Bonjour. In this video, we shall talk about interrogatives in French. We shall learn how to make interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences are sentences which are used to ask questions. Questions may be asked using a question word. Question words are interrogative pronouns, adverbs, or adjectives which are usually placed at the start of a question. In English, there are words such like what, why, how, who, or how many. In French, there are words like quand, qui, pourquoi, or expressions like qu'est-ce que c'est que. Out of this, quand means what, pourquoi, why, qui, how, qu'est-ce que, what, and qu'est-ce que c'est que also means what, but in a more informal context. French has got some specific question structures. When the question word qui is the subject of the question, meaning who is the subject of the question, then the question word introduces the question and is followed by the verb. The auxiliary if there is one, otherwise the main verb, and then by any other parts of the sentence. Qui means who. So, when the question word qui is the subject of the question, then it introduces the question and then is followed by the verb, the auxiliary if it exists, otherwise the main verb. In all other cases, the question word introduces the question and then is followed by the verb, the auxiliary if there is one, otherwise the main verb, which is followed directly or indirectly by the subject. The basic structures are the same in both cases. As you can see in the first one, qui est vous. Here, qui is the subject of the question. Who are you? So the subject is who. In the second one, que faites-vous? What do you do? Here, you is the subject. And what is the question word quand? Qui refers to people and means who or whom. That is, it can be subject or object depending on the context. Quand refers to objects, everything except people, and means what. And is almost always the words are the object of a sentence. However, occasionally quand can be the subject of a question. You can see the examples. First, in the example 1 and 2, it shows qui, but it's working as a subject or object. First example, number 1. Qui mange au resto ce soir? Who's eating at the restaurant this evening? So the question is who is eating, means who is the subject. So qui is the subject in this sentence. Number 2. Qui voyez-vous? Whom do you see? In this case, you are being asked whom do you see. That means qui is the object. Now the way to distinguish between subject and object is simple. Subject is the one which performs the action. An object is the thing or person on whom the act of action is performed. Object often answers the question whom or what. Whom or what. In the second example, whom do you see? So you see someone, but whom do you see? So the answer to that whom is the object. In the first example, who is eating? Qui mange? Who is eating? So someone is eating, but who is eating? So there, qui is the subject. In example 3, que pense-t-il? What does he think? So he thinks something, but what does he think? So que is the object. Qu'avez-vous dit? What did you say? You said something, but what? Que is the object. E becomes an apostrophe because the next word begins with a vowel. In the fifth example, Prospastil. Prospastil. What is happening? In this case, ka is the subject. Because you are asking what is happening. So something is happening, but what is happening? So that is, in this case, it becomes, ka becomes a subject. This is an idiomatic formation. Prospastil. Qui is often replaced, especially in spoken French, with the expressions qui est qui, when it's the subject, and qui est quoi, when it's the object. The word is put first, qui, and then that est qui, the second qui, shows whether qui is the subject or the object. Quoi is often replaced, especially in spoken French, with the expression qu'est-ce qui, is the subject, the second key shows that it's the subject, or qu'est-ce que is the object. A qui refers to people and means whose. A quoi refers to people and means of what. Number 6. A qui est téléphone. A qui est téléphone. A qui means whose. So whose telephone is this? Qui est déjà allé à Montréal? Who's already been to Montréal? Qui is the subject. À quoi appartient cette pièce? What does this part belong to? Now, pièce might mean very many different things. Pièce can mean a coin. Pièce can mean a part. Pièce can mean a play or a theater. So it can be translated according to the context. So whose part is this? To what does this part belong to? Because it's à quoi. If it had been à qui appartient cette pièce, then it would have been whose part is this? À quoi pense-t-il? What is it thinking about? À quoi pense-t-il? What is it thinking about? Interrogative adverbs are often used in asking questions. Où refers to place and means. Quand to time and means when. Quand can be replaced by, or sometimes it's expanded to, quand est-ce que. Où va ce train? Où va ce train? Où sont les toilettes, s'il vous plaît? Où sont les toilettes, s'il vous plaît? Quand pensez-vous venir? Quand pensez-vous venir? Quand est-ce qu'il va pleuvoir? Quand est-ce qu'il va pleuvoir? Here, quand is expanded to quand est-ce que. The second E from quand becomes an apostrophe because the next word begins with a vowel I. Pourquoi, meaning what? Pourquoi pleure-t-il tant, l'enfant? Pourquoi pleure-t-il tant, l'enfant? Pourquoi refers to cause or reason and means why. Comment refers to method or means, meaning how. And combien or combien de refers to quantity, meaning how much or how many of. Pourquoi dis-tu cela? Pourquoi dis-tu cela? Comment allez-vous? Comment va-t-elle s'expliquer? Combien pèse ce paquet? Combien d'argent avons-nous? The interrogative adjectives quel and its different forms. Quel in all its forms implies a choice between or among nouns that it qualifies. It can mean which or what. Being an adjective can qualify as a noun. It's mostly used attributively just before the noun, but sometimes can be used predicatively with the verb it. And because it is an adjective, it must always agree with the noun. Quel goût de rencontre? Quelle heure est-il? Mais quelle idée lui est passée par la tête? Quel est votre avis? Quelles sont les bonnes réponses? Quelle était sa réaction? Long forms of the question are often used in everyday spoken French. It starts with qu'est-ce que, or où est-ce que, or quand est-ce que, because questions starting this way are mistakenly questions. For questions starting with a short question word like quoi could be misheard and misinterpreted. For example, you can become confused between qu'avez-vous and avez-vous. However, if you say qu'est-ce que vous avez vu or a similar expression, then it becomes quite clearly a question. You must note that when questions are formed using qu'est-ce que or a similar expression, there is no inversion of subject and verb. Que pensez-vous? But qu'est-ce que vous pensez? Qui est-ce que? The precise expression used depends on whether the question refers to a human or an inanimate object, and whether the question concerns the subject or the object of the statement. Here you can see, qui est-ce qui is a human subject, qui est-ce que is a human object. Whether it's human or non-human is shown by the first key, and whether it's a subject or object is shown by the second statement, qui or que. Qu'est-ce qui is the inanimate subject, qu'est-ce que is the inanimate object. When que starts a short form question, it's almost always the object of the verb. Que penses-tu? What are you thinking of? Or what do you think? The long question form, the short equivalent, and sometimes there are no inversions when appropriate. It depends on the context in which it is being used. Qui est-ce qui aime le chocolat or qui aime le chocolat? Both are possible. Qui est-ce qui l'a épousé or qui a-t-il épousé? In spoken French, qui est-ce qui l'a épousé is the one which is more commonly used. Qu'est-ce qui vous surprend? Que vous surprend-il? Again, in spoken French, is the first example which is more commonly used. Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Or que se passe-t-il? Both may be used. Qu'est-ce que vous en pensez? Qu'en pensez-vous? In spoken French, it's almost always the first example, because the second could be confused. Lequel est-ce que tu préfères? Lequel préfères-tu? Often, either one may be used. So, we can see there is no inversion when qui is the subject of a question. Que, when it's used as the subject of a verb. In this example and in modern French, que vous surprend is not generally used, and certainly not que surprend vous. So, in this, we use qu'est-ce qui vous surprend. In example number 3, or sometimes que vous surprend-il. Most of the time, as you can see, the long form is most common. In the fourth example, surpasser is an existential verb, and it can be commonly used in a short form question starting with que as a subject, except with verbs which include arriver, exister, survivre, and suivre. In number 4, in example number 4, you can see qu'est-ce qui se passe or que se passe-t-il. That brings us to the end of this video on French interrogatives. Au revoir.